Hi, my name is Steve Houston. Welcome to my channel where I discuss all things related to financial services, their products, compensation plans. We compare the IMOs and where the standard is. Where I choose to offer my opinion, I back it up with third-party documentation to counter my rhetoric, as some people would say. That way I can supply it to you and you can make your own decisions. It's all about you. And listen, I just came back from a Florida vacation, and I gotta tell you, I'm so grateful and blessed to have all of you to be part of this channel. It's growing. I encourage you to share it out to other agents that are out there that are struggling. Maybe they're with an IMO or they're with a recruiter who hasn't got a clue how to sell insurance, but just bought into the get-rich-quick scheme of recruit, recruit, recruit. Don't get those three things out of order. And, you know, I can find a couple of people that are going to make me wealthy. As you know, I don't like that kind of stuff. I don't like being forced to recruit in order to get advanced on my own contract rate, on my own personal production. I believe you and I should be paid on the value that we bring to the IMO, which is what I write with my own pen. If I choose to build an agency, certainly compensate me for that. But if I'm a top producer, pay me like a top producer. I mean, look, I get calls and emails. I've got hundreds of calls, emails, and text messages since I got back from Florida. Obviously, the video I placed live from the beach impacted many of you. And I got to be honest with you, this is, you know, what we do matters. We do a great thing by going out there and helping our clients protect their families, keeping those dreams intact, leaving a spouse and the kids with something left of their dreams, where their dreams are not shattered by the loss of the major breadwinner. All that's great. It's the best job in the world when it comes to getting paid very, very, very well. So well ought to be illegal, but it's not. And then be able to just really do a good thing. And it's a great feel-good occupation. But at the end of the day, you've got to make a decision and move yourself. Maybe many of you, we had a call last night with our agents, and we struck a chord because, you know, look, people need to move themselves forward. This is a great opportunity, and the opportunity is here and now, right now, here in 2019. I don't know when you're watching this video, but 2018 was a fantastic year. 2019 has been better. 2020 is going to be phenomenal. But look, the T in timing is more important than T in talent. You've got to get in, but you got to make sure you're getting in with somebody that has a time-tested and proven training system and is not just a recruiter going through the motions. Many of these people haven't even got their licenses yet, and they got them on the phones recruiting because that's how they're going to make their money. Wait a minute. Newsflash. We're in the business here of selling life insurance, specifically in the mortgage station and final expense arena. That's what we do. That's our core business. It's not in credit repairs, right? We are in the business. You and I are life insurance agents, and we get compensated very, very well to do what we do by the carriers, which is going out there and selling them some life insurance, right? So we didn't need, that's a big warning sign to me if we're having to go out and sell other products. Because if you focus on a core business and you learn some key fundamentals, which is, you know, how to book an appointment, working a leads-based sales opportunity, I don't know if there's anything else more important than you being able to grab a lead, make a dial, book an appointment, run the case strategy, choose whatever product you're gonna offer them in the home, and go out there and make a presentation. What else is there that's more important than that? Right, so you've got to get very, very good at product selection. You have to get very, very good at being able to convert a lead into an appointment. Otherwise, you're not going to succeed here, and you're not going to make any money. So being with a recruiter who never has sold, how is that going to help you? And why would you want to be in that position? Why would you want to be with somebody that's going to cap your income if you don't start out right out of the gate recruiting? These are the questions I would ask you if you and I get on the phone. So look, I am more than happy to help you compare the IMOs. Some of you may want that kind of environment, may want that type of network marketing, you know, rah-rah stuff. And that's great. At least we can figure out which one best fits you, okay? There are some trade-offs out there, as I talked about before. I've got videos out there. Up here's one of them, which is the biggest head fake in the industry, which is a high contract rate, right? High contract rate, no leads, no mailing house. In other words, when I say no leads, doesn't mean they can't get leads. It means that they don't mail. They don't have any mailing house. They're buying third-party leads, which means they can't control the quality of the lead, and that affects you. Not the IMO, it affects you, right? So that's the first thing. Then, because this whole thing about recruiting, if you want to build an agency, and I think you should in time, when you're able to leave from the front, put your name on an application, and by the way, Why would you sign with somebody that doesn't lead from the front? That's never done what he's asking you to do. That's an integrity issue. So we can have that conversation. And it's not necessarily about you coming over here to our agency, although we have a great agency and the best IMO. But when you ask me the number one question, which is the best IMO, it's not that easy. I mean, for me, it is. I know there's only one best IMO out there. Okay, that's for me. Now, that may be different for you, and we can have that conversation. But really, if you're brand new to the industry, you're just joining me, you're trying to transition from a job, this is a big decision. It's a critical decision. And you have to make sure you're with someone that considers that a partnership, not a sign-up thing, and has a training program that they can plug you into that's time-tested and proven, and that that guy signing you up understands that he expects you to go out and lead in the front, or at least you've done that in the past, and can teach them something. If a guy that's recruiting you is a recruiter, never sold anything, and not even licensed, what do they have to offer? Especially the IMO doesn't offer any training either. So you've got to be careful of that. I would encourage you, as hundreds do, shoot me a text, send me an email, and let's get on the phone. You may have to give me a day or two to get back to you, but I will get back to you, and we will have that conversation. Because it's very, very, very important to your success. And that's what this channel is about. That's why I don't mention what IMO I'm with. These are videos that help you succeed. And let me tell you something. You know, as I move into this video, this part here is more important than any product knowledge you'll ever know. Okay? There's two things you got to get good at. One, actually three. One, you got to get good at converting a lead into an appointment. Otherwise, you can have all the product knowledge in the world, but you can be driving around. You're not going to get into the house, right? Then it's product selection. If you don't choose the right products, they're getting declined or they're getting rated. They're not getting the policy and you're not getting paid. Those two things we help you with every single case. On the phone, working with you on that case. So you're prepared to go in the home. That's the kind of coaching I'm talking about. The third thing, which actually should be number one, is controlling your attitude. Okay, we're in business for ourselves. How you view things and how you react to things, right, is going to determine the level of success or any success that you might have here, right? So, look, control the things that we can control. We can't control someone pulling out from us in a car and cutting us off in traffic. That's out of our control. But we can control how we react to that situation. And when it comes to our going out in the field, not getting the sale, they're not home, all that kind of stuff, You control that. You can't control them canceling. We all go through that. It's a sales position. But you can control your attitude. You can control the number of leads that you purchase. You can control the number of dials that you make. And regardless of how many times you get ports or you get to the house and it's a no-show, you can control that as well. You can't control them canceling or not shooting, but you can control the numbers, and that means you can control your activities. This is the law of large numbers. So if you call me up and say, Steve, I need to make $5,000 a week, I can tell you what type of leads you need to buy and how many appointments you need to set in order to make that $5,000 per week. And then it's up to you to do the activity to get those appointments. And it means if it takes 10 appointments per week to do that, you can't start out with 6. You can't start out with 3. You can't start out with 9. You got to have 10. So this weekend, I need to move on because I've spent a lot of time already talking about that. I don't even have a clock here, but I'm sure it's been time enough. So this week is part two of the video I did, which I'll put up here, is how to choose the right type of mortgage section and final expense coverage. Now, we went over this the last time we were together, and this is the exact board we were using. Okay, I'm looking at my monitor here to make sure I didn't step out of the picture. How to choose the right type of mortgage section, final expense coverage. We based it on a 45-year-old male, good health, non-smoker. We compared the four main types of insurance coverage, which is term, guaranteed universal life, and guaranteed universal life express, which means non-med. We compared whole life, and we compared the IUL, the indexed universal life products. Now, which one of these products would be good for final expense, and which one would be good for term? The answer is all of them. Right? You can use any of these to solve that problem. If someone needs mortgage section insurance, typically speaking, any of these products would work. There's no final expense policy. Those are things we're trying to solve. We're trying to sell them a life insurance policy to help them deal with final expense. We're trying to sell them a life insurance policy to help them deal with a mortgage section in the event the major breadwinner passes away, the house is protected. So you could do that with any of these products, right? But there are two products here that really fall into the category. So understand, if you're going to go out in the field and you're going to talk to somebody about mortgage protection insurance, typically speaking, for mortgage protection, it's going to be a term policy, right? Term policies, which means it's going to be around for a certain length of term. So 10, 15, 20, 30, term. It terms out at the end of 15 years. And typically speaking, you'd match that to the mortgage. So they have a 20-year mortgage, sell a 20-year policy. Except for return of premium, which I love. So I always go into a home, that if they're a young couple and they qualify for return of premium, which means that if they don't die, the insurance company's happy, they're happy, we're going to refund them up to 100% of the money they paid in for this term policy. If they have a 30-year mortgage, they can get a 20-year policy, and typically speaking, the money that they're going to get back will pay off the remaining 10 years of their mortgage. Mortgage protection tends to be a term life insurance product. And again, the reason why is it terms out, and you can kind of line up to the length of their mortgage, although it really has nothing to do with their mortgage. It's just is there so the beneficiary can use those funds to pay off the mortgage. It's not attached to the mortgage like mortgage protection insurance is. This is not. This one, you get to choose who the beneficiary is. They can alter the mortgage. They can refinance, all that stuff, which they can't do with a mortgage protection policy. They can do with a life insurance policy because there's no connection to it, to the actual deed in the house, or to the mortgage. If you're looking to solve a final expense solution for a client, typically speaking, that's going to be whole life. Lower face amount, lower death benefit. We're only dealing with final expense, right? 10, 15, 20,000, whatever it is. Whole life, you can go up to about $100,000, so between $5,000 and $100,000. Why is a whole life policy better for final expense solutions? Easy. Whole life. That means the product's going to be around for their whole life. And usually, it means they're going to pay for it their whole life, and it's going to be there for their whole life, whereas a term will run out. This is where many, many people get themselves in trouble. They buy a lot of term. About 70 years old, it starts to run out. Past 80, it's gone, right? And they don't have anything for final expense. Now they're too old to get a lot of whole life, and they end up with a $2,500 or $5,000 policy, which you and I both know doesn't do them any good. It doesn't really cover much of the final expenses at all because the death benefit is so low. If that's all they have, there's still value to it, but then it comes down to the budget, right? So typically speaking, if you're going to be going out and talking to somebody about mortgage protection, it's going to be a term product. If you're going to talk to somebody about final expense, it's going to be a whole life product. Now, the Index Universal Life could also be used for final expense, right? It could also be used for mortgage protection. So, and so can the GULE or the GUL. Again, the E only means express, meaning that it's non-med, no needle, right? But these tend to be more expensive than the whole life policy, which typically is going to run a $5,000 maybe $100,000. There's some variables in the product, and it will be there the whole life. So this is going to run out. They're going to have this until they're 95, 97, 99, 102 on some of them. It'll be there for their whole life. It'll be there when they pass away to handle final expenses. Because again, it's the face amount or the death benefit is going to be lower. So when people talk about, I want to sell final expense, or I want to buy final expense leads, or I want to buy mortgage protection leads, or I want to work only mortgage protection, it really, well, look, we sell life insurance. So you can solve any of those issues with any of these products. But usually, mortgage protection will fall into the term category. Final expense will fall into the whole life category. Make sense? So when someone says, I want to work only final expense, this is why I don't recommend signing up with just a final expense company, right? Why would you limit your options? See, I have mortgage protection, I've got final expense coverage. If someone wants to fund a retirement, I've got that this year. If someone wants to fund a retirement, I've got this year. Or I've got college funding, and I've got some retirement planning. All four of these things allow me as an agent to solve most needs. It just depends on the budget and what they're trying to solve. Hope that makes sense. Remember, there's so much in life that you and I do not have control over. But the one thing that we do have control over is our mindset and our activity, right? I would encourage all of you to take time, invest in yourself, read some books, get your attitude in check, take a serious look at how you react to situations that come up every single day, Remember, control what you can control. There are certain things that we can't control, but this is a fantastic industry. Here's the one thing you can't control, and you know I'm getting ready to say. And that is the surest way to return to succeed is to never, ever quit. You've got to be willing to fail. You've got to be willing to be bad before you're good, because we as humans learn by failing. Fail forward, never quit, because if you quit, you're quitting on yourself. Look, I got some two or three videos coming up. Go through them all. Enjoy. Reach out to me if I can help you. That's what this community is all about. I'm grateful for all of you, and I'm blessed to be sitting here and able to help you. Bye-bye.